I'll be talking about the different clinical applications of interior segment OCT. OCT was introduced in 1991 to image the posterior segment of the eye. It's only recently the anterior segment OCT has become available. There are various anterior segment OCT devices in the market, and each has its own distinct advantages. The dedicated anterior segment OCT scans use 1310 nanometer wavelength light, and they give us much wider and deeper scans with higher resolution as compared to systems converted from retinal scanners that use wavelength of 830 nanometers. Add-on lenses are also available with systems which are designed primarily for posterior segment imaging, like RTView. It uses cornea anterior module, which is of two types, CAM-L and CAM-S, that provides us with various scan options. You can visualize the detailed anatomy of the cornea, starting from tear film, epithelium, Bowman's membrane, stroma, Desmond membranes, and endothelium. One can also visualize the detailed morphology of anterior chamber angle. And coming on to the clinical applications of anterior segment OCT, it can be used to assess the corneal thickness and opacity to evaluate pre-surgical and post-surgical anterior segment anatomy. To also helps in guided laser-assisted cataract surgery to image the intracorneal ring segments and to see the position and wall size of the ICL. Keratoconus can be diagnosed on anterior segment OCT based upon four parameters in central 5 mm pachymetry zone. We see the inferior to superior and infrotemporal to superior nasal octant asymmetry. The minimal thickness should be less than 470 microns, and minimum to maximum difference should be less than 100 microns. This is how a normal cornea looks like on anterior segment OCT scan, and it also gives us progression pachymetry thickness maps. Now, this is a case of keratoconus. The pachymetry is 435 microns, and the superior nasal to inferior nasal octant difference asymmetry is 61 microns. So this indicates keratoconus. High resolution OCT can also gives us detailed information regarding the changes which are happening in the stroma and Desmond's membrane during process like acute high drops. Like breaks in Desmond membrane and pseudocyst formation can be visualized. And these days we are doing C3Rs for keratoconus, and the OCT tells us the demarcation line, which is a direct clinical sign of cross-linking. It is usually seen after a month of cross-linking procedure, and depth of the demarcation line can be visualized, and perhaps in future can be related to the effectiveness of treatment. One can also see the see and assess accurately the depth and position of intracorneal ring segments. And in the refractive practice, it's very important to visualize and see the whether the flaps which we are making with the keratome or with laser procedure, femto laser, are of desired thickness or not. Anterior segment OCT measurement allows us to measure the thickness along the entire range of the flap. Like these scans show that the flaps which are created with the femto laser are more uniform and thinner as compared to the flaps which are created with keratome, which are thicker and are of meniscus shaped. It's also useful in planning the management of corneal scar. If the scars are, for that we need to know the depth of the corneal scar. If the scars are superficial, we can just peel it off, or if they are full thickness, we may need to advise the patient a full thickness keratoplasty. Like this is a patient who presented to us with the central corneal scar. He underwent LASIK surgery 2 years back. And at present, his best corrected vision was 6/9 with -2 spherical and -1 cylinder. And he complained of lots of glare because of the central visual scar. And he was keen on getting the re-surgery done. We did anterior segment OCT to see the scar depth, which tells us that the scar is 186 microns deep involving the flap as well as anterior stroma. So we decided to peel off the scar rather than doing the more invasive procedure. This is the image scan of the same patient 1 month post surgery after amputation of the flap. There is minimal scarring in the interior stroma, and the patient at present has a 6x9 vision with -2 cylinder, but the glare has reduced markedly. It's also helpful in planning LASIK enhancements, as it can visualize the flap even after years of surgery. Like, this is a patient who had -2.25 diaspherical refractive error 8 years after the primary LASIK surgery, and he wanted recorrection. So we divided interior segment OCT to visualize the entire thickness of the cornea, which the OCT measures the thickness to be 461 microns. The flap thickness was 126 microns, leaving a residual stromal bed of 335 microns. So we can safely proceed with relifting the enhancement by relifting the LASIK flap rather than doing PRK. Now, this was a case where the patient had a white patchy area of milky appearance in the periphery of the flap edge, and it was a case of epithelial ingrowth. The interior segment OCT showed the epithelial ingrowth to be much broader in size, and also there was thinning of the overlying flap. So this patient needed surgical intervention. OCT has also become a very important tool for the corneal surgeons, as it helps to monitor the health of the desic graft. It provides us the information regarding the position of the graft, attachment of the graft to recipient, quality of the interface, and corneal thickness. This was a patient who presented to us with a dense corneal scar and aphakia. We did combined procedure of desic with glued IOL. And you can see that the graft post-surgery is very well, there's a nice attachment of the graft to the stroma. And you can also see if the graft is detached on day one, so that you can intervene earlier. The most recent and exciting advancement in cataract surgery is the development of femto laser-assisted cataract surgery. Most of the devices, they use real-time OCT integrated in it, and they can visualize the whole of the interior segment up till posterior capsule, and these scans are very rapid. You can also see the morphology of the corneal incisions made post-surgery. Like, this is an incision which is made with the femto laser, which is biplanar, and this is a manual incision made with manual keratome, which is uniplanar, and there is endothelial misalignment, and this scan shows a small DM detachment. DM detachments can also be managed properly by using interior segment OCT scans. You can also see the relationship between IOL and the capsular bag. Like, this is a patient who had capsular bag distension syndrome. There was a fluid sequestration between the posterior capsule and the IOL. And we did YARC caps, and with a single shot of YARC caps, there was a release of fluid into the vitreous cavity and the distension resolved. Then another important application is to know the to calculate the size of the vault size of the ICL, which is the distance between the posterior surface of the ICL and interior surface of the crystalline lens. The adequate vault size is very important. It should be around 0.5 to 1 corneal thickness, and like this scan shows the vault size to be 244 microns, which predisposes this patient for the cataract development. Then there are various other applications which I'll just enumerate. It can be used for IOL power calculation post-LASIK surgery, in dry eyes to measure the tear meniscus height, for lamellar keratoplasty to see the donor-host alignment, in infective keratitis to assess the depth of the corneal ulcers, and in all the interior segment tumors to visualize and see the and monitor the tumors. So OCT, I feel, is a very underutilized interior segment device, but it's applicable to assess a wide variety of interior segment and corneal disorders. Thank you.